TJ, I think we're about to you. TJ, what did you say my last, what did you say my three unknowns were in this question? What's one of them? Okay, well, what are the different, what are the different things can change? What are the things that can change?
The cost.
Cost. So what letters do you give for cost?
I didn't.
Do what? Oh, okay. So now let's see equals cost. That's okay. All right, Aiden, what else is new as unknown?
How many adults and how many kids?
So A is going to be the number of adults. And K is going to be the number of kids. If you want to be mathy, you can use X, Y, and Z if you want to. It doesn't matter. The point is, at the beginning of your statement, you have to use that let statement that I call it. Okay, describe. If you tell your mother C equals 14 plus 2.38 plus 5K, unless she's a math teacher, she will not understand you. Okay, yes.
Do I have to use the C for cost?
No, you can use M for cost and use whatever.
No, but no, I'm saying so for 8 plus 5.
Well, in this case, you could have yes, but it says describes the daily cost. So if you didn't do that, that's okay. Okay. Okay, can somebody be brave here, please? Madison, you get an expression by any chance? Okay, well, I'll help you out. What does $5 per hour mean for an expression? What does $5 per hour mean? An expression. Ask? Okay. Excuse me? 5A sounds good to me. What does $2 per child mean? Go on, Sydney. Okay, that's a good start. That's looking really well. Caitlin, what's my expression already? What else did I just need to put in there, please? $8. So it should be something like this. What does all that together equal? Those are C, right? So if you didn't put down the equal C, that's okay. We're getting into making equations. That's called an equation. It's written on the board. Don't be afraid. That's called an equation. Kyra, I'm going to close your eyes for a quick second. Who got that expression without the equal C or just with the same thing? Who got that expression? Raise your hand, please. Who came close to me in a small mistake? Who had no idea what was happening? Okay. Raise your hand, please. Today's lesson is all about making sure you understand what's on the board. Okay, that's today's lesson is all about. Okay, so if you weren't good at this, that's okay. We'll have lots of practice. Part B says, Mrs. Solinger brings three adults and 28 students to the Y. How much will this cost? So let's take a second here.
Can we just do expression?
Yeah, the expression is fine. Okay. All right, Angela, let's make sure we got it. Mrs. Solinger brings three adults and 28 students to the YMCA. Now, I don't want me to confuse you. Mrs. Solinger is one of the three adults. I'm not being tricky saying there's four adults, okay? I'm just saying three adults is all we're using, okay? How much will this cost? Angela, do you have any idea of how to find out the total cost or what we do? I think you said 5 times 3, and that's right, okay? So we're going to set A equals to 3, and K equals to 28. Okay, so we're going to use that expression that we built from the first place, and we're going to replace A with 3 because there's 3 adults, and we're going to express K with 28 because 28 is in the class, all right? So what that would be is then 8 plus 5 times 3 plus 2 times 28. Please be brave and ask if you're not sure what just happened there. Once you get the expression, you're going to replace the number of adults with 3, The number of kids is 28, yes, go ahead.
So I think 5 to the power of 3.
Not to the power of 3, it's 20 times, not to the power. Okay. We'll deal with the power, what those expressions look like. So you take if there's 3 kids and $5, you use 3 owls and $5 each, it's not going to be 5 cubits, it's going to be $125, it's going to be 15. Curtis, are you confident in your math skills?
Yeah.
Perfect. What is 5 times 3, please?
13.
And what is 2 times 28?
56.
Hey, Lily, I'm sure of driving skills. 8 plus 15, please, is? 23 and 56 is?
79.
79, awesome. Now, in grade 9, I'm not sure how much you did this in grade 8, but life is going to change right now. If you are given the question in a sentence, you have to give the answer in a sentence, too. So this is something called a concluding statement. I wrote one of these on the board the other day, and nobody knew what this meant. This is just your concluding statement. Now, therefore, this means therefore. Instead of telling your mother that C equals 79, what would you tell her? What would you tell Ms. Franwerger in this case? Owen, go ahead.
Therefore, 79 is the cost.
Very good. Therefore, this will cost $79. That's fine. If you really want a level 4 answer, you could say 3 adults and 28 students will cost $79. Okay, right?
But it more marks for that?
No. It would have to be, but it would have to be something that's clear. Again, the idea is if you do this to your mother and you give her this, you tell this song to C equals 79. This song is a very intelligent person, but she does not understand C equals 79. If you tell her it costs her $79, she'll understand. Okay? So does it make sense a little bit?
It costs
sort of like that. It will all cost the thing. It costs... Yeah, about 3 probably. 31, a little bit less. Okay, here we go, example 4. Yeah, I want you guys to try this for yourselves here with the expressions, the last statements, and all that stuff. Okay? So again, the only way to do this stuff, it's not going to magically appear in your head. Yeah, okay, right? This one you got to practice a little bit and do a few of them, it'll be fine. Okay. This is my type of question. Loves the movies. We're in example 3, that's why I've written here. Is it 3 or 4?
Example 4.
Go to the movies. It costs the family $5. Costs $11 per adult ticket. $8 per child ticket. And $9 each snack. Does anyone here work at a movie theater? Nobody? You guys go to the movies? Snacks are hideously expensive at the movies.
You can just watch
that. That's true. But let's say Avengers Infinity War was coming out.
No one really wants to watch Avengers, so.
Except for math teachers. Math teachers are into that sort of thing.
You can go to like $10.
You know, you're allowed to bring your own snacks in there.
No,
right?
You're not.
There you are.
No, you're not.
You totally are.
No.
You have to hide
in your coat.
Totally not. Yeah, you go over to like the dollar store. Hey, you're
right.
If they don't find it, like
5 cents,
and then
you just like put it in there. Hey, write an expression. For the cost. To go to the movies. Each variable. Okay, so try and follow the same way. So start with your last statements, okay? Think of what your unknowns are here. So your unknowns will probably be your total cost again, the number of adults, the number of students, the number of children, and the number of snacks. We don't know how many are altogether, I'm just gonna pause and make sure you guys get the expression. The expression part is what I really want.